I love you, Allah.
First way to prepare yourself for Ramadan is first of all to realize the purpose of Ramadan. Because Allah Azza wa Jalla says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. All you who believe, fasting has been made obligatory for you, like it was obligatory for those who came before you, so that you might increase in obedience to Allah and decrease in disobedience to Allah. So in preparation for Ramadan, you need to be prepared to be more obedient to Allah and less disobedient to Allah, to do more sunan and to do less haram, and to do less disliked actions. It's very important that in this, you put the fard ahead of everything. Unfortunately, there are some people, Qaddar Allah, who they pray Taraweeh and they don't pray Fajr. Or they pray Taraweeh and they don't pray Dhuhr and Asr. This is not accepted from you, because Taraweeh is a sunnah. It's a recommended action. It's not an obligation. Okay, so what we want to see is people praying their 5 daily prayers and Taraweeh, inshaAllah. But if you're going to leave one of them, then leave Taraweeh and focus on the 5 daily prayers, because these are those that are obligatory for you. And you can't come close to Allah except by those things that Allah has made obligatory. You can't come close to Allah by the optional deeds. So focus on the obligatory. As for the optional deeds, things like Taraweeh, things like standing in prayer, things like reciting a lot of the Quran, these are all things you need to be focused on in Ramadan, and memorizing and acting upon it and learning it. As for the end of Ramadan, then what you need to focus on is continuing your efforts after Ramadan. Because the sign that someone's deeds have been accepted is generally what? That they are given the ability to continue doing good deeds after that. Okay, so if you see people are continuing doing good deeds after that, then inshallah ta'ala, this is a sign that their fasting has been accepted. And if you see someone disobeying Allah Azza wa Jalla on the day of Eid and stopping praying and going out clubbing and drinking and whatever, then know this person had no fast. Allah Azza wa Jalla did not accept their fast. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, had He accepted their fasting, He would have given them the ability to do good on the day of Eid. So your day of Eid is a test for you. If your day of Eid is a day of obedience, the fasting has been accepted, inshallah. And if your day of Eid is the worst day of the year for you in disobeying Allah, then this is a sign that your fast has not been accepted. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to accept our fasts.